Good evening. Here we have a rechargeable lithium-ion battery, an ESP01 module, a pair of pin headers, a pair of 470 ohm, 2.2 kilo ohm and 12 kilo ohm resistors, two LEDs and two buttons. And this is a Wi-Fi socket. If I press this blue button, its color changes to red, and this ESP01 module also gets the information of the new color. If I press the button for another time, on both devices, the blue LEDs turn on. And if I press this red button, on both devices, red LEDs turn on again. Now, let's connect to this Wi-Fi socket a big motor, and when I press this blue button, we can turn the motor on and off wirelessly. So, this is our topic today. Today, our ESP8266 microcontrollers will control big mains currents in a relatively safe way. This Orvibo S20 socket is actually meant to be used with a Vivo smartphone application. So, for starters, download the application to your smartphone. Ordinary customers pair up their sockets with their home Wi-Fi routers and then they can turn their sockets on and off with their smartphones. But we will cheat the socket a little. Our socket, yes, will think that it is paired to an ordinary home Wi-Fi router, but in fact we will pair it to our ESP8266 microcontroller. I'll show you how to do it. This is the Wi-Fi router that I usually use at my home. It is connected to the internet via a mobile phone connection. And from the other end, it is connected to my computer with a USB cable. You, of course, have a different router module at your home, but they all work on the same principles. So, Google for the user manual of your Wi-Fi router. Find out the local network's homepage address for your router and find out the password that one needs for changing the settings of your router module. For instance, mine password seems to be 12345 and this is the address of the administrator's page for the router. Find among the settings your router's service set identifier, SSID, and its password. Write them down so that you will remember afterwards how to return back to your normal settings. So, today my router will get for a little while a new identity, Vivo, and it will accept a password HiHo0001. The Orvibo manual recommends us at this point to check that our router's dynamic host configuration protocol, DHCP, is enabled. As you see, mine already was enabled. Originally in Germany, also here in Finland and also in 34 other countries, we use this kind of sockets. But you can buy exactly similar Orvibo S20 sockets that will fit to your North American, Australasian or British socket standards. Now connect your socket to the mains current of your home country. You should now see a red LED blinking at the button of the socket. If you don't see it, reset the socket to its factory settings by pressing the button for several seconds. Now press and hold the button for 5 seconds until the rapidly blinking red LED changes to a blue colored LED. Go to the Wi-Fi settings of your smartphone, write down the name of your current access point so that you can afterwards return back to these settings. Select this new Vivo access point and start the Vivo smartphone application that you just downloaded. tap this button that has three dots and three lines. Choose this More button. Tap this AP Configuration button. Select from the list our newly made Vivo router and type the new password HiHo0001. Tap OK. You should now see that the LED has turned to a stable red. From this moment on, our socket will look for a router that has the name Vivo. Connect to that access point with a password HiHo0001 and it will think that it has got a connection to some home router. Go back to the device list. In some YouTube videos, they have to tap the plus and search buttons to find this S20, but in my case, it just appeared by itself on the device list. You can select it and test how to switch your Orvibo socket on and off with the help of your smartphone and home router. But actually, we don't need the Vivo smartphone application anymore, and you can close the application and delete it. And remember to put your smartphone back to its previous settings. And we won't need the modified home router anymore either, so you can change it back to its normal SSID name and back to its normal password. Let's now power up our microcontroller. ESP01, as in the beginning of this video, or any other ESP8266 module will do. I will start here with a factory-made Node MCU development kit. It is easy to use and it is very stable. To find out the media access control address, that is to find out the MAC address of our socket, go to this discussion thread started by Dr. G at the ESP8266 community's webpage. I am personally very grateful to this page for the information that I share with you today. Don't hesitate to create your own account and log in so that you can get the two programs that we need today. Download and unzip the files and open this Orvibo Discovery Test program with your Arduino IDE. My Arduino IDE had a somewhat old version, 1.6.7, and I had to move the loop function with its contents to the end of the entire code. Hopefully, they will soon change the order of these functions so that you don't need to do this extra work. Anyhow, run the program and copy this MAC address and its so-called little endian to the clipboard of your computer. Now start the Orvibo on-off test program. Change to these three lines the newly found MAC address of your Orvibo socket and put to this place the little endian of the MAC address. And again, in some versions of the Arduino IDE, you may have to move the loop function with its contents to the end of the code and also move the S20 subscribe function with its contents to a place of the code before the S20 on function. And we see that we indeed can control Wi-Fi smart sockets directly with our ESP8266 microcontroller. What a fine product! The ESP01 module in the beginning of this video was programmed with this do-it-yourself development kit that has the same practical auto-uploading feature as the Node MCU has. If you find this kind of do-it-yourself development kits interesting, watch our previous video. And here we see, controlling a lamp, an ESP12 module without any Node MCU, but instead with a soldered version of our do-it-yourself development kit. The module here isn't quite as versatile as the ESP do-it-yourself modules in our previous videos. But the one important aspect is that this ESP do-it-yourself module is approved by the American and European authorities. So, if you find such official ESP do-it-yourself modules interesting, watch our next video. Thank you, Orvibo Company, and thank you for your interest this evening. Goodbye.